Hello, welcome to my fishing flies in the Blues Man Cave. The blues today is Davy Hall, a very good blues guitarist. It's nice to have a concert with him today. Today we are going to tie one of my oldest fly, ant, a flying ant, called in Norwegian Vingus Mavrus, and that's one of my oldest pattern who I fished many years, both salmon, grayling, sea trout. It catches everything in size 10, and I tie it in 14 and 16 also, but 8, 10 is for the big ants here in Norway when they are swarming. The materials, the body is black superfine you can use, or black fluorite, but from the start I tied it with black antron, but antron is not so easy to get hands of these days. And the hook I'm using two hooks, RX 502 and 500. The 502 is a little bit lighter, and I normally use that in the lakes, and the more heavier hook, the 500, in the rivers. The tying thread, mainly use Uni 8.0, but sometimes I also use Webus 14.0. It's very good threads, both of them. Post, Aero Driving, in that color. And in the middle section of the fly, between the back and front body, I use this fly right, Rusty Orange number 18. That kind of ant is not orange in the middle, but I think it's a little hot spot for a trout. And the hackle, I'm loving Cree, whitening Cree. Yes, that was I used the most, but everything like this you can use. Even regular brown you can also use. This fly is almost 30 years old now. It was when I was a kid, I was sitting in the local lake and the ants were swarming, and I didn't have anything to match the hatch. So I went home on my bicycle, tied this fly, get back, and I've used it since. Every season I use this fly, and it's very effective. I also used it a lot on New Zealand, and the fish are standing in deep water, and you present that fly, he comes and takes it. It rises from deep water. And it's also fine to have a dropper with a nymph in the behind of it. So, okay, I think that's everything with the materials. Then we start tying. Okay, welcome back. Here I have finished a Vingus Mavrus. Something important with this fly, the hackle. This is the main standard of the length of the hackle, approximately down to the end of the hook. That's a good size. And 3 to 5 wraps. I also do a version for lakes, less hackle. And this for some fast water in the rivers. And this works like hell. And important to get the back body a little bit thick, and just cover the middle with orange, and a front body and a good head. That's important. And we will not have a toilet brush hackle on this. This is fishing fly. It will be some not so very nice hackle. It's fishing flies. Okay. Let me put you down there. You can swarm here with your friends. Yes. And size 10 hook, like that. There is straight. Okay. Today I'm using my unit thread, black. Starting up here. Tying myself back to ish here. and I go in front again. Here I will place my post or the wing like that, and I'm using this one. I take one straw, like this. I cut it off in the bend after the sides here. Then I put it under and up like that. Fasten it good like that. I do a cross turning here. Then I spin my thread anti-clockwise and I make the base for the hackle like this. It's important to get high enough because the dubbing is covering a lot of the length. Oi. About here and down again like that. And I do some cross tying here, and it sits put like that. Flatten my thread again. I go back. Back to there in the bend. Then I take, today I have a super fine dry. Some importance with the dubbing of the back body is to make one tight layer in the first. You shall not put a lot of dubbing on your thread and do an easy big body. You make a foundation here, like this, to here, and go back again, and some wraps over. Like that, and I take my time building up a solid body. It takes some time to build a body with the right proportions. It should be a little bit thicker in the back. As you see, I don't dub much at once. Just take my time. And the water will not go so fast into the dubbing. And you can take many fish on it without breaking the fly or ruin it. Like this. More dubbing. This is also a fly, which is very good as an attractor or searching pattern. Sometimes in the forest or in the river, when there's no rising fish, I can use this fly on the streams, in the edge of the streams, in the pockets, in different places to search for a fish. And very often they rise at it. Maybe it's the profile of the body who lures them up, like this. Oh, even more. This is a very easy dubbing to use. But my favorite is the fly rite. Even more, I have to build up a little bit towards the post. A little bit thin there. Then I tighten it a little bit like that. Oi. Tighten. And I'm soon finished like that. That will be a nice body. Then I take a thin layer. And for me, the fishing flies is more important than the Instagram flies. These have to be practical, good fishing flies. Like this. Now I finish down to the middle. Now the hackle. It's better to have too big hackle than too small. You can't have too big hackle, and it, you can have it up to this, no problem. But back of the hackle in front of me, I tie it in like that. Like that. Couple of turns. And I take my plier to drag it. There, I think. Like that. And I work my way up. And down again. Before I cut off the end, I check it. That's okay. Then I tie this up like that and cut it off. I can promise you guys it's not easy or even not very fun to speak English. I flat my thread again like that. Then I take the hot orange. And it's just to cover up. Don't dub big bulk of dubbing. Just cover the area. So less dubbing, like this. Just cover the thread. Like that. And there, there, other side. And then I'm just looking under. A little bit more, just a little bit. There. There we have it. Like that. Okay. Now we have two options. I can do the hackle right now and dub the front body after, or I can dub the front body now and do the old hackle later. My dogs are here. Like that. I take the hackle now and I dub later now, this time. First turn, hackle plier I don't want to use today. Like this, like that. That's okay. Hold everything up. Tighten. And before I start tying, I've waxed my thread. Cut it off. And take the rest here. Like that. More dubbing. Every time I tie this, I don't normally know how to do this front part. It gets different every time. Like that. To the place. Like this. That. Hold up. Making a nice front part, even a little bit more. It's very important to have the right proportion on this fly. Now we see there. This is good. There. And it's important to make a head that is quite big. So we have a very nice head for the ant, because the ants have a quite big head like that. Then my finish. And I make it a little bit higher on the top. Oi. Like that. More on the top. Like this. I don't bother to varnish this fly. Like that. Then I have to fix the hackle. Okay, some backlash in the strands here. I can cut off in some backlash here. There. Here we have it. Flying ant, Vingus maverus. Like that. And the post height about here. There we have it. The Vingus maverus. Look, the proportion of the body, very important. Don't have too small or short hackle. Not make a toilet brush hackle insta type. Make it a fishing fly. Thank you for watching my YouTube channel. See you again soon. Bye bye.